give you an idea of the size of this thing. It was me walking from one end to the other. Turn the camera around in a minute and show you some of the details going on in here. It's a little bit crazy. But this ain't a koi pond, it ain't even a fish pond. First bit of crazy is there's a wall. You can't quite see, you'll see in a minute when I turn the camera around. You've got wall ties. Wall ties in the end of that and wall ties here. It's going to be a wall built on top of the fiberglass along here. No, a pipe. Fiberglass is going to come off that. What are we going to do about that pipe? Oh no.
Oh no. Oh God.
Maybe that's going to stick to that.
Oh my
if I put some extra bonding paste near that pipe, it'll stop it coming away. What the fuck do I do? Only 10 fucking years worth of videos on YouTube all about it, mate. Everything closer to where I'm working is that this has all been swept up and cleaned to a point. More of that in a minute. Boom. No bottom drains in this. Good. God knows what I'd have done if there were bottom drains. Right, turn the camera and show you what's going on. Right, I'll paste this out from this corner. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and a bit on that straight run. This to foam line yet. This is that synthetic decking rather than timber. And there's whatever it sat on underneath there. And as you know, we would prefer the copings not to be on. This is the preformed sheet that I made in that other video with the aquarium.
So we don't
like the copings to be on, but that is the detail if the copings are on. Because the thought of me asking them to take these copings off after they've been put on, a bit of a nightmare. Scaffold roof leaked. Patch of water down there this morning, see where it's all dark. This is the chamber with the preformed sheets in it. That's where I was going to piss on his chips a little bit further about black flow coat and black resin, but I can't be bothered with that anymore. So I was explaining that if you tried to fiberglass this inside here, you would have a very bad day doing it, and you would have some very vivid dreams on the night. It was basically a confined space. No thanks. So preformed sheets bonded to the walls with a bonding paste, leaving only the joints and the floor to piece in. Oh no. Oh God, what am I going to do there? There's another pipe. Oh no. Right, floor. Now bear in mind, there's no bottom drains in this. It's not even for fish. This floor is going to be covered in rocks and gravel and all sorts. There's a wall being built along here where these wall ties have stayed in. And I've just worked around, so four there, and three there. Now they're going to miss, or they're going to delete the perps out of the blocks or bricks, what fit there, and it's going to act as some kind of filter that goes off to this other pond, which is down there, with a liner in it. So my plan now is to hit this all out with resin as normal. Concrete, being concrete, it's just going to kick up dust. I can sweep that 100 times and it will still kick up dust. So whilst I'm wetting the foam out with resin, which again, it's not 100% necessary, but it's just good practice, I'm going to seal the floor with resin as well. And that is good practice to do that, because A, any remaining little bits in the concrete that have been brushed up won't be getting into my roller and contaminating the fiberglass with rocks like that, because it seals them all back. It will also mean for a smoother fiberglass job, because it will fill these little divots, lines all across there. Not that the fiberglass wouldn't do that anyway, with 2 450s on it. It basically just seals everything back, and what that also prevents later on is any air that might get trapped in there if you just glass directly to this concrete without sealing it. This air in a little pocket like that, or anywhere on this floor, can expand and you get this little humped, raised air void. So if on the rare occasions I do fiberglass straight over concrete these days, I pretty much always put a seal over it first, but I'm going to wait for that, or I can assist that drying out actually with my blower, which I blew all of the dust out of that when they cut that 45 out of the top of the block. So I'll get the blower on that in an attempt to dry that up before we put the resin on, because having done this so many times, you know at what point is acceptable moisture or otherwise, I mean ideally zero, but there is a point you can work with it being slightly damp, but like I say, you'd ideally want it dry. So just those last few pieces of foam to put in, smash it all out with resin. That'll take me up to God knows what time, what temperature we've got. Very comfortable 14 here at the minute. It's not half past 12, that's way out. It's more like 3 o'clock in the afternoon with an 100-mile drive on under my belt. Can't believe that leaked. It's just the window, the overlap on the overlap from that sheet of corrugated is 400 mil. So how it got blown in, God knows, but it would have to do it last night when I'm imminently on my way down here, having delayed this job from last week because it was biting cold all last week. Absolutely no chance of standing doing it, even under a cover like this. So let me crack on before that bonding paste goes off. Last bit of tidying up to do, and then like I say, smash it all out with resin, leave it till the morning, and then start glassing. Easily achievable for me, even at my old age now, is to fiberglass the walls tomorrow. Quite easily achievable on a nice steady day. No tissue going to be wasted on this job with what it's for, especially with rocks and things going to be strewn all over this floor. It's not that I'll be doing a shit job to a double standard. I will, when I'm doing the floor, carry on and wet the walls out with more resin until I'm happy that, you know, it's a nice enough finish for me. So walls, glass tomorrow, floor easily achievable on Wednesday morning. Thursday, smash the flow coat on, boom. Big job like this, scaffold it. Nothing else is going to survive the big winds, especially what we've had of late. Ah, these little black sheets up here, they're what went up extra that the company's put up on top of this corrugated because it leaked. So they've gone out and bought a big load of that, and because the sun comes round in that direction, the sun came through and put an impression of light onto the floor down here, which I don't want, so that's a nice little help as well. Right, I shall crack on, got work to do.